We're going to fight this. We're going to use every appeal avenue. And we're going to fight. I'm going to spend every waking hour fighting for Julian until he's free, until justice is served. And the UK should not be doing that. It should not be engaging in persecution on behalf of a foreign power that is out for revenge. That foreign power that committed crimes which Julian put into the sunlight. Specific, concrete crimes that have not been prosecuted, that have been just shoved under the rug. And Julian, who has done nothing wrong, he has done everything that any self-respecting journalist should do when given evidence of a state committing crimes of corruption. They publish it because their duty is to the public. And Julian's duty to the public has landed him in prison for already more than 3 years, and he faces 175 years. This is a political case. It has to be resolved at the highest levels. Let's stop pretending. There is no legality. The only thing on display is illegality. Illegality by the powerful players that are trying to keep Julian silenced forever. He's an Australian citizen, he has rights, and of course the Australian government has to stand up for its citizens. Julian did nothing wrong. He published evidence of war crimes and of criminality committed by a state. He received that information from a source, and it was in the public interest. He should not be in prison. He did nothing wrong. It is the public interest, the public's right to know, that is being criminalised.
Next step is to seek permission to appeal in the High Court of this country. We will appeal it all the way, if we need to the Supreme Court. If we're unsuccessful there, we will seek to appeal to the European Court of Human Rights, because this case is so important, not just for Julian, but for all media workers, all journalists, all editors in this country.